In a few days the little weekly published in the Glen under the name of The Journal came out as usual, and the Glen had another sensation. A letter signed Faith Meredith occupied a prominent place on the front page and ran as follows. To whom it may concern. I want to explain to everybody how it was I came to go to church without stockings on, so that everybody will know that Father was not to blame one bit for it, and the old gossips need not say he is, because it is not true. I gave my only pair of black stockings to Lyda Marsh, because she hadn't any, and her poor little feet were awful cold, and I was so sorry for her. No child ought to have to go without shoes and stockings in a Christian community before the snow is all gone, and I think the WFMS ought to have given her stockings. Of course, I know they are sending things to the little heathen children, and that is all right and a kind thing to do. But the little heathen children have lots more warm weather than we have, and I think the women of our church ought to look after Lyda and not leave it all to me. When I gave her my stockings, I forgot they were the only black pair I had without holes, but I'm glad I did give them to her, because my conscience would have been uncomfortable if I hadn't. When she had gone away, looking so proud and happy, the poor little thing, I remembered that all I had to wear were the horrid red and blue things Aunt Martha knit last winter for me, out of some yarn that Mrs. Joseph Burr of Upper Glen sent us. It was dreadfully coarse yarn, and all knots, and I never saw any of Mrs. Burr's own children wearing things made of such yarn. But Mary Vance says Mrs. Burr gives the minister stuff that she can't use or eat herself, and thinks it ought to go as part of the salary her husband signed to pay, but never does. I just couldn't bear to wear those hateful stockings. They were so ugly and rough, and felt so scratchy. Everybody would have made fun of me. I thought at first I'd pretend to be sick and just not go to church next day, but I decided I couldn't do that, because it would be acting a lie, and Father told us after Mother died that was something we must never, never do. It is just as bad to act a lie as to tell one, though I know some people right here in the Glen who act them, and never seem to feel a bit bad about it. I will not mention any names, but I know who they are, and so does Father.